Hello students, today we are going to learn about the topic 2D rotation transformation. Now let's see the introduction. (Music) 2D rotation is a process of rotating an object with respect to an angle. Means in 2D rotation we have to rotate the object with certain angle. The rotation can be done in clockwise or in anti-clockwise direction. Whenever we perform the rotation, we can do it in both the ways, clockwise or anti-clockwise. Now see this figure. What we can see from this figure? The object can be rotated at an angle theta from its origin using the rotation. Now here we have seen two angles. One is a phi and one is theta. Phi is the angle between the x-axis and the radius r to point P. Okay, so P is having the coordinate x and y. And if we move the P, we rotate the P to certain angle, we will get P dash having the coordinate x dash y dash. So we will call this angle as a theta. So it is observed that point P x comma y is located at an angle phi from the horizontal x coordinate with distance r from the origin, which we have seen now. This is a phi, which is between the x-axis and the radius r to point P. It is assumed that a point is again rotated at an angle theta. Now this point is again rotated at an angle theta to get a new location. We will call it as P dash. So we get the new point, that is P dash in bracket x dash y dash, the new coordinate of this point P. The two types of rotations are anticlockwise rotation and clockwise rotation. Whenever we perform the anticlockwise rotation, the rotation angle is always positive. And whenever we perform the clockwise rotation, the rotation angle will be always negative. So we can see it with the help of this diagram. If we rotate it in an anti-clockwise direction, then point P will be come here as a P dash, and when we perform the clockwise rotation, we will perform in this way. So Q point, we will get the new point as a Q dash. So in this way, we can perform the anti-clockwise and clockwise rotation. Now let's see how the rotation matrix is done with the help of this formulas. Using the standard trigonometric, the original coordinates of point P x comma y can be represented as, now these are the trigonometric functions. We have already studied it in our schools. So x is equals to r cos theta and y is equals to r sin theta. Or we can also use here the phi angle or a theta angle. It is up to us. So here we are referring this diagram. So we will write it as a x is equals to r cos phi and y is equals to r sin phi using the trigonometric equations. Now, the same way we can represent the point P dash. Here, we have written the coordinates of point P, that is r cos theta comma r sin theta. Now, we have to represent this P dash point with the help of trigonometric equations. Now, how we will represent it? X dash is equals to r cos phi plus theta. Why it is phi plus theta? Because with respect to this x-axis, this is a phi angle. Okay, first we rotate it with phi and then again we rotate it till theta. So we will write it as x dash is equals to r cos phi plus theta. And then y dash is equals to r sin phi plus theta. Now we have to use here the formula of cos A plus B and sin A plus B, which we have already studied in schools. So let's write cos phi and theta is nothing but r cos phi cos theta minus r sin phi sin theta. And sin phi plus theta is nothing but r cos phi sin theta plus r sin phi cos theta. Now we have got here the four equations 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now we have to substitute the equations 1 and 2 in 3 and 4. because x is nothing but r cos phi. So here we are having r cos phi also, and y is nothing but r sine theta. So here we are having r sine phi. So we substitute the values of this x and y here. So we will get the equation x dash is equals to r cos theta minus y sine theta, and y dash is equals to x sine theta plus y cos theta. Now we can represent this equation in a matrix form as this: cos theta minus sine theta cos theta. So this is the equation for 2D rotation in a matrix form for x dash and y dash. That is a new coordinates of point P dash. Means we are moving the P by rotating it with certain angle theta to get the new coordinate of P dash, that is x dash y dash, where R is the rotation matrix in anticlockwise direction. So this is the matrix for the anticlockwise direction: cos theta minus sine theta and cos theta. Same matrix we have to write here for the anticlockwise rotation. Now, as we have seen, in clockwise direction the angle is negative. So we will write it here: cos of minus theta minus sine of minus theta, and sine of minus theta cos of minus theta. So cos of, as we have seen here, cos of minus theta is always cos theta, and sine of minus theta is minus sine theta. So after replacing these values, we will get the rotation matrix x in clockwise direction as cos theta sine theta minus sine theta cos theta. In this way we can get the rotation matrix for both clockwise and anticlockwise direction. Now we can also represent this 2D rotation with the homogeneous coordinate. So as we have seen, it is a 2D rotation, so the homogeneous coordinate, if we add it, then the matrix will be of 3 by 3. So we can represent it like this way: cos theta minus sine theta 0, sine theta cos theta 0, and 0 0 1. In the same way, we can write the matrix for the clockwise direction with a 3 by 3 matrix: cos theta sine theta 0 minus sine theta cos theta 0 and 0 0 1. So these are the two matrix if we want to represent it with the help of homogeneous coordinate. So this is all about the 2D rotation. Thank you.